Hello students, welcome to the EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Shyok Sharma, Assistant Professor and DBT Ramalinga Swami Fellow from Department of Biochemistry, All Indian Institute of Medical Sciences, New Delhi, India. Today I am going to talk about module Transport of Macromolecules from Paper Membrane Transport. As we learnt in previous module that plasma membrane of the cell function as is selectively permeable and allows only small amount of molecules to be freely transported across the membrane. Small molecules and non-polar can easily pass the non-polar bilayer by diffusing in the membrane and crossing it as discussed in the previous module. Charged molecules and macromolecules cannot freely pass the membrane. Charged molecules require channel, pumps and ion carrier to cross the membrane. But macromolecules being large in size fail to cross the membrane through these channel transporters. So, the transport of the macromolecules such as protein, polysaccharides and polynucleotides across the membrane is also important. So, the objective of today modules is how do these large particles enter and exit the cells? What are the mechanisms of vesicular transports which transport these macromolecules? We also study about endocytosis, which are like phagocytosis, pinocytosis and exocytosis, and mechanism of non-vesicular transport, what is nuclear pore complex lipid transport. So depending upon the nature and chemical properties of the macromolecules, macromolecule protein, lipids like this, are transported in the cells by two pathways. First is the vesicular transport and second non-vesicular transport. So in vesicular transport, most polar macromolecules like protein get transported by this mechanism or this pathway. But through non-vesicular transport system, the non-polar macromolecules like lipids get transported through non-vesicular transport. So, if we discuss about the vesicular transport, so macromolecules like which are intended to internalized by the cell from extracellular environment are dependent on the vesicular transports. So this type of transport is very important for maintaining intracellular environment as macromolecules cannot freely diffuse and pass the membrane. So transport of molecules, the molecules which are undergo transport are classified as charged molecules and macromolecules. Charged molecules generally are transported through channels, pumps and ion carriers, while macromolecules are undergo transportation through vesicular transport or non-vesicular transport. Vesicular transport we classified into two categories like endocytosis and exocytosis. Endocytosis are phagocytosis and pinocytosis. Similarly, exocytosis we classified as calcium triggered non-constitutive and non-calcium triggered constitutive transport. Membrane transport between endoplasmic reticulum and Golgi can be divided into two pathways. Anterograde pathways means from endoplasmic reticulum to the Golgi, and retrograde pathways from Golgi to the endoplasmic reticulum. So, during membrane cycling, exocytosis and endocytosis continuously replace and withdraw patches of the plasma membrane. New membrane protein and lipids are made in the endoplasmic reticulum, modify in the Golgi bodies, and form vesicles that fuse with the plasma membrane. The Golgi apparatus, as on this figure, is often found in close proximity to the endoplasmic reticulum in cells, and protein cargoes move from endoplasmic reticulum to the Golgi, which is undergo modification within the Golgi apparatus and then sent to the various destinations in the cells, including to the lysosomes and cell surface. So, what is exocytosis and endocytosis? Exocytosis means out of the cell. So, under this phenomena, the fusion of a vesicles with the cell's membrane, releasing the content to the surrounding. While during the endocytosis process, the formation of the vesicles from cell membrane, enclosing the material near the cell surface and bringing them into the cell. So, this is the main difference between exocytosis and endocytosis. Macromolecules, which are intended to internalize by the cell from extracellular environment, are dependent on vesicular transport. This type of transport is very important for maintaining intracellular environment, as macromolecules cannot freely diffuse and pass the membrane. So, endocytosis is a very important phenomena to transport such kind of macromolecules. So, endocytosis is a process by which membrane-bound vesicles carrying macromolecules are derived by the invagination of cell plasma membrane, followed by pinching off and release of free vesicles in the cytoplasm. This type of process are need lot of energy, and these are, in other words, these are energy dependent process and require ATP. As in our previous modules, we said that the process which required the ATP are called active process. So, endocytosis is a active process. Different types of endocytosis like phagocytosis, pinocytosis, receptor-mediated endocytosis. We will discuss one by one in detail in later slides. So, endocytosis, we classified into three pathways like phagocytosis, pinocytosis, or receptor-mediated endocytosis. In phagocytosis, pseudopods engulf the target particles, might be bacteria, cell debris, and merge as a vesicles. Later, they fuse with the lysosomes, where lysosome enzymes are present there. They degraded the all debris or bacteria kind of things, and finally remove the cells by fusion with the cell membrane. Similarly, in pinocytosis, which means bulk phase endocytosis, pinocytosis is called drinking. So, in this case, extracellular fluid is captured in a vesicle and brought into the cells, and it is reverse of the exocytosis. Receptor-mediated endocytosis, here some specific molecules which bind to the surface receptor and make the enclosed structure, they are enclosed and make an endocytic vesicles. So, these three different pathways are describe the phenomena of endocytosis. As shown in this picture, this solid particle representing the bacteria, as this bacteria approaching the plasma membrane, these making the projections and make the pseudopodiums. This pseudopodium making the phagosomes, engulf and making the phagosomes. And these phagosomes particles are dissolved in extracellular environment. So this is the phagocytosis. Similarly, in pinocytosis, these fluid particles are come in the vesicles by the vesicular formations. And in receptor-mediated endocytosis, there are a lot of receptors on the plasma membrane which recognize the ligands and making the coated pits. And these coated pits taking around all their ligands and make the coated vesicles. And these receptors recognizing the molecules and internalizing them. Phagocytosis means engulfment. The phenomena of phagocytosis were discovered by Russian scientist Ilya Mechnikov. Later, he also got the Nobel Prize for his great discovery. Phagocytosis basically involves intake of large particles, example bacteria, cell debris, or even intact cell by cells. When particles which are intended for internalization bind the receptor present on the cell membrane, then pseudopodia is formed around the particles by actin-based movement of the cell membrane. As shown in this picture, the phenomena of phagocytosis required signals, membrane receptors, formation of pseudopodium, and cortical actin network, which form the vesicles called phagosomes. When pseudopodium surrounding the particles fuses a large intracellular vesicles, these large intracellular vesicles is called phagosomes. These phagosomes fuse with the lysosomes to form phagolysosomes, in which ingested particles are digested by lysosomal enzymes. Some internalized proteins are recycled to the plasma membrane. It is an active and highly regulated process involving specific cell surface receptor and signaling cascades mediated by Rho family GTPH. The predominant cells which play important role in phagocytosis are unicellular cells, macrophages, osteocytes, and trophoblasts. These predominant cells play flowing important functions like uptake of the fluid particles, immunoresponses, and elimination of the aged cells like RBCs and other. Now we discuss the role of phagocytosis in living systems. How phagocytosis is important? First, consider the case of protozoa like amoeba. Amoeba capture their food. Food means bacteria and other protozoa by phenomena of phagocytosis. That we'll discuss detail in the later slides. And phagocytosis also play important role in defense mechanism. So during the defense mechanism, these cells like invading microorganisms, they kill them and eliminate all microorganisms and damaged cells from the system, body system. In mammalians, macrophages and neutrophils are the professional phagocytes, means they are the play important role in immune defense. This figure showing the mechanism of amoeba phagocytosis. Here, this picture shows internalization of bacteria by amoeba and formation of phagolysosomes and digestion of bacteria. As shown in amoeba, these are the lysosomes and nucleus. When bacteria is come near to the amoeba, they create the pseudopods and engulf the bacteria. These pseudopods are fused with the lysosomes and making the phagolysosomes, and after digestion, waste product also expels outside the body. So this is the phagocytosis is an important mechanism for digestion or food and absorption of the nutrients in the amoeba. Similarly, phagocytosis also play important role in defense mechanism. Here, pseudopods sound the pathogens, and after making the pseudopodium, these cells undergo endocytic vesicles formations, and these endocytic vesicles are fused with the lysosome vesicles with the enzyme which digest the pathogens. And after digestion of the pathogens, cell used to digest the material and expel throughout the body. Pinocytosis is not as specialized as phagocytosis. It is performed by the most of the eukaryotic cells. It involves the ingestion of fluid and solute via small vesicles. Receptor-mediated uptake is selective, which is best characterized form of pinocytosis. Non-selective pinocytosis also present in nature. There are different mechanisms of pinocytosis like macropinocytosis, clathrin-mediated pinocytosis, caveolae-mediated pinocytosis, and protocytosis. Macropinocytosis, it involves the membrane ruffling and ingestion of the macromolecules. Similar to phagocytosis, Rho family GTPase trigger the actin drive formation of membrane protrusions. But unlike phagocytosis, macropinocytosis does not involve zipping up of membrane, but the membrane collapse onto the fuse with plasma membrane and form macropinosomes. These vacuoles have no membrane, and their mass surface ratio is 0.2 to 0.5 millimeter. This picture representing the detailed mechanisms of macropinocytosis, how cells using the macropinocytosis for trapping of the macromolecules. Macropinocytosis have following significance, like liquid phase pinocytosis, and it taking the probe from the environment for antigen recognition in macrophage. So, in receptor-mediated endocytosis, the molecules which are intended for internalization bind to the receptor present on the cell surface. So, those receptors bind with the cell surface are specialized region present on the specialized region of the plasma membrane, and these are like clathrin coated pits or caveoli. These receptors, these vesicles help to the receptor mediated endocytosis process. Clathrin mediated pinocytosis. In this type of pinocytosis, macromolecules bind to the cell surface receptor present in clathrin-coated pits and enter the cell as a receptor ligand complex. Clathrin is a core protein which has three heavy and light chain, as shown in this figure. These proteins assemble at the cytosolic side of the plasma membrane by interacting with adapter proteins. Different adapter proteins are present at different intercellular compartment. For example, dynamin. Dynamin form rings at the neck of invaginated clathrin-coated pits and have suggested that a conformational changes in the ring, which correlate with GTP hydrolysis, play an essential role in vesicle fission. Clathrin-coated vesicles play very important role and have diverse functions. These vesicles play important role in receptor-mediated endocytosis. They are selective uptake of molecules and act as membrane receptors, and concentration of ligands is more than 1000x. So, now we discuss the what are the functions of clathrin-coated vesicles? So, clathrin-coated vesicles play crucial role in receptor-mediated endocytosis. They are very specific and selective toward taking uptake of the molecules, and they are act as a membrane receptor, and their concentration of the ligands up to 1000x. So, caveolin mediated pinocytosis. In this case, caveolin basically is the major protein which is present in the caveolae, and this protein caveolin bind to the cholesterol molecules and force the lipid bilayer to curve inward, lead to formation of rounded shape like structure called caveoli. And dynamin is another protein which is required to pinch off the membrane and deliver its component to the endosomes for the processing of ingested macromolecules. Caveoli mediated pinocytosis. Caveoli is a flask shaped 50 to 80 nanometer bottle like enfoldings that are present on cell surface and are rich in cholesterol and sphingolipids. Caveolin is the protein responsible for the formation of caveoli on the cell surface. Here, electron microscopy image representing the fibroblast caveoli. This cartoon picture representing the caveolin oligomers and caveolae assembly. Caveolin is the transmembrane protein having both N-terminal and C-terminals are the present in the cytoplasmic side of the cell membrane, and these oligomers are joined together and making the caveolae assembly. As shown in this cartoon pictures, caveolin bind to the cholesterol molecules and other lipids and force the lipid bilayer to curve inwards, lead to formation of caveoli. Once caveoli is formed, and other molecules like dynamins is required to pinch off the membrane and deliver its component to the endosomes for the processing of the ingested macromolecules. As we know that dynamin is required to pinch off the membrane and deliver its component to the endosomes for the processing of ingested macromolecules. In these pictures, you have seen that dots represent here binding of anti-dynamin antibodies, and long neck shows that how the coated pit was formed, but due to the absence of GTP hydrolysis, its punching off is absent. So thus, we conclude that dynamin is required GTP hydrolysis to punching off coated vesicles. Now, we discuss about the exocytosis. Exocytosis is an active process, means it requires the energy ATP molecules, and during the process of exocytosis, the secretory vesicles carrying the signals from the plasma membrane fuse with the membrane and release its content out of the cell in the extracellular environment. So there are some specialized secretory cells which are secrete the product which are required by the organism for specific functions such as hormones, enzymes or neurotransmitter. All these are going through the process of exocytosis. Exocytosis we classified into two categories, non-constitutive exocytosis and constitutive exocytosis. Non-constitutive exocytosis, it is the regulated exocytosis which an external require signals, a specific sorting signals, a clathrin coated or calcium ion triggered. While in constitutive exocytosis, release of the components after fusion of the transport vesicles with the membrane and is triggered by calcium or non-calcium trigger. This picture representing the detailed mechanism of both non-constitutive and constitutive exocytosis. Here, Golgi apparatus releases the newly synthesized soluble protein for constitutive secretion, and same time new plasma membrane lipids are synthesized as well as newly proteins for plasma membrane also synthesized and make the vesicles, which is making the unregulated membrane fusion. And in other hand, when signal transductions like signal molecules, hormone and neurotransmitter are accepted by the receptors, they are starting the cascades of signal transductions, and secretive vesicles are formed in the trans Golgi network, and these release the secretion in regulated way by regulated membrane fusion. This slide representing the transmission electron microscopic image of exocytosis. Here we clearly saw the secretory granules during the exocytosis targeting the vesicles. When vesicles from one site of generation migrates towards its target, it requires some set of proteins which help vesicles to recognize the correct partner and to fuse together. Vesicle, as on this figure, vesicles fusion with its target membrane is mediated by interaction between specific pair of proteins called SNARE or SNAP receptor on the vesicles V-SNARE and target membrane called T-SNARE. Complementary SNARES determine the selectivity of the fusion between vesicle and the target membrane. V-SNARE present on donor vesicles recognize the T-SNARE which is present on the target membrane. Then RAB-GTP hydrolysis yielding RAB-GTP in cytosol which can be reused for another cycle. To give energy for the locking of donor vesicle onto the target membrane, this phenomena is called docking. A vesicle then fuses with target membrane and the SNARE complex bind to NSF like NEM sensitive factor via adapter protein, snaps soluble NSF attachment protein is an ATPase that utilizes energy of ATP for dissociation of SNARE from each other. Now, next we discuss the non-vascular transport of the molecules. During non-vascular transport of the macromolecules, it involves some that allow large molecules to pass through them. For example, like nuclear pore complex, which is present in the nuclear envelope around the nucleus, and some molecules like being nonpolar in nature can pass the membrane like lipid transport. So these are the examples for the non-vascular transport of the macromolecules. Nuclear pore complex. Nuclear pores are found on the surface of the nuclear envelope. These pores allow for the transport of macromolecules into and out of the nucleus. The complex forms an elaborate structure. Each pore size is around 12.5 million Dalton. It has octagonal symmetry measuring some 100 to 150 nanometer in diameter and 50 to 70 nanometer in thickness. The pore comprises of different proteins which are known as nucleoproteins. Peripheral filaments are attached to the core, filling the central hole on a basket-like structure on the nuclear side of the nuclear pore complex. Each pore complex contains 456 protein molecules and about 30 different type of proteins. So during This type of transports, like ions, small metabolites, and globular proteins up to 60 kilodalton, are able to diffuse through the water filled channel, and large proteins like ribonucleoproteins complexes, which are very big and to diffuse in and out of the nucleus. So NPC basically play to transport such kind of molecules, and this is also very selective in nature. Also, the system transporting protein like RNPCs bigger than 60 kilodalton also go through that selective transport and work by the assisting the other molecules. Or water soluble transporter will bind with the molecules that interact with the nucleoporins to allow for movement across the nuclear envelope. The targeting of the proteins into or out of the nucleus required specific amino acid sequence spans termed nuclear localization sequence or NLS sequence or nuclear export sequence. Example, the classical NLS is the simple 5 amino acid peptide K, 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 R, K, necessary and sufficient for targeting its attached protein to the nucleus. Each signals also interact with a specific receptor proteins called importins and exportins. The receptor protein binding the signals are termed karyopharynes. During nuclear pore complex translocation, soluble transport factors are required to either bring cargo to the nuclear pore complex or modulate cargo translocation across the nuclear pore complex. Most of these soluble transport factors come from the family of proteins known as the karyopharynes. Karyopharynes are further divided into two classes, importins and exportins. Importins proteins, they are selective transport into the nucleus and contain in nuclear localization signals, while in exportin transport protein out of the nucleus, and it also settle tRNA and ribosomes between the nucleus and cytoplasms. These molecules contain nuclear export signals. So now we discuss about the lipid transport. As we know, beta oxidation take place in the mitochondria, but fatty acyl CoA are present in the cytosol. But long chain of acyl CoA cannot freely diffuse across the membrane. So a transport molecules and transport protein is required for transportation across the mitochondrial membrane. So the acyl group of the acyl CoA is transferred to carnitine in the cytosol and releasing CoA in the cytoplasm. This transfer reaction is catalyzed by carnitine palmitoyl transferase 1. You see all this procedure in the pictures in the next slide. So this acyl carnitine complex, which is transported into the matrix by carnitine carrier proteins. So here carnitine carrier protein is a play very crucial role to transport the acyl CoA. In the matrix of acyl group is transported to acyl CoA and regeneration of the acyl CoA in the matrix. This transfer the reaction from carnitine to CoA is catalyzed by carnitine palmitoyl transferase 2. So carnitine palmitoyl transferase 1 and carnitine palmitoyl transferase 2 play crucial role during lipid transport, and free carnitine is transported back to the cytosol for another round of the transport. So in that way, lipid transport is happen in the cells. So you will look out all this mechanism in the next slide in detail. This figure representing the detailed mechanism of lipid transport, how lipids are transported within the cells. So, student, let's now summarize what we have learnt from in this module. So, we learnt that transportation of the macromolecules across the membrane is an active process and is essential to maintain the homeostasis in the living organism. As being large, they cannot freely pass the membrane and require some special type of transport. Macromolecular transport is broadly categorized into two, vesicular transport and non-vesicular transport. In vesicular transport, molecules are transported either outside, means exocytosis, or inside, means endocytosis of the cells. Endocytosis is further classified as phagocytosis, pinocytosis, receptor-mediated endocytosis. For vesicular transport to be efficiently performed, certain targeting protein and receptor proteins are required, certain wrap proteins and snares. In non-vesicular transport, molecules are transported across the membrane through the pore formed by the protein in the membrane, thus no vesicles are formed. As in vesicular transport, some proteins are required for transport of the macromolecules in non-vesicular transport. Thank you.